Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Splashedpost. I am sad to tell you that Splashedpost is no more. In the few hours I played after last video, Jurist McPick, the final one of the original seven, succumbed to an infection from a wound he received in defense of Splashedpost. So, Splashedpost is, as of this video, officially over. However, since I felt it would kind of be cheap-ass to just make a 10-second video telling you that, I figured we should go through the history of Splashedpost and see if anything interesting happened. So, I'm going to try and find Splashedpost in the list here. There we go! Splashedpost. Rulush Hithev. Or however you want to pronounce that. So, Splashedpost was a mountain hold. The Crystal of Owning. That's just a perfect name for a group. So, here's the original seven. MacMiner, MacPick, MacMason, MacDead Elf, MacElf, and MacMetal, and MacLoved. And they settled. And then we had some migrants. Yours MacMason created a masterful claystone door. Wow, yay. died from thirst. Yeah. So, Wilhelm, Moonshine, Roxas, Rainbow Dash. Now wait, these are new settlements. Let's just die from thirst. Two guys died from thirst. Then we had migrants, among who were Wilhelm, Moonshine, me, Roxas, Rainbow Dash, Nina, the zombie, and Xenogard. Hell, there's a lot of migrants. Okay, moving around. Here's the next year in which Dr. Copper British visited or settled in Splashedpost. In the late summer of 153, Earthen Drums, the Bronze Sounds, was created in Splashedpost by the dwarf Jurist MacPick, Recluse Diamond. Seriously, that's his name? Well, whatever. Became a furnace operator, administrator, created a masterful pine barrel. Did something more into it. Ah, okay. Here comes Key Reaper in the mid-autumn of 153. Okay. And here we go. Tobul was struck down by goblins. Zasit's spattered labors was struck down by the goblin. The Silver Scimitar. Usud. Jurist MacElf created a masterful time barrel. Gave up being an administrator to become a clerk. Interesting. Jurist MacElf. He keeps creating these masterful barrels. Go you, I guess. Wilhelm was struck down by goblins with a copper whip. Jurist MacMetal was struck down by a goblin with a copper whip. Seriously, these whips, they need a nerf. Jurist MacMason, blah blah blah, masterful, masterful, masterful. Xenogard, however, became a furnace operator. Well, congratulations. And my goodness, lots of them. And here's a lot of struck downs. Did we have invaders? Yes, we did. I have a feeling this is when Splashedpost just went pear-shaped. MacElf created a masterful larch bed. MacMason. More settlers. Draylon, welcome. In 154, midsummer. Ahem. The dwarf Tickwit bled to death, slain by the goblin with a copper short sword. But so far it seems no one of us have died except for the four in the beginning. More settlers or migrants. Lots of masters full things. And here comes the Died of Thirst. Xenogard died from thirst. Moonshine died from thirst. Jurist McLeod died from thirst. Rainbow Dash died from thirst. Jurist McDelil died from thirst. Yeah, about that. So this has to be when everything went totally out of whack. And people started throwing tantrums and getting killed by him. Yeah, here's where everyone runs straight out to get killed by the goblins. So basically, who died here? Jurist McElf? No, he created a barrel. I'm trying not to miss anything in this blob of text. Jurist McMiner died from thirst. The zombie died from thirst. Jurist McMason, Machine Strike, was struck down by the dwarf Logan Roachins with a steel battle axe in Splashedpost. Okay, so McMason was killed by a dwarf? Okay. Logan bled to death, slain by the goblin Osnum, Dreadful Slit. I almost read that dreadful shit, but okay. The Fortitious Quill of Cruelties with a copper two-handed sword. Blah 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 blah. Bastards. Nina bled to death, slain by the same goblin. Dr. Copper British struck down by the goblin, same damn goblin with his two-handed sword. Roxas struck down by another goblin with a short sword of silver. Jurist McElf struck down by the goblin, blah 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 blah, with a silver scimitar. Key Ripper bled to death, slain by another goblin with a copper short sword. Draylon, you were slain by a silver scimitar. And then we have settlers, or migrants. Holy crap. Heh. And here they start rising again. The dwarf Diggalock City came back from the dead as a restless haunt. Ah. You know, there's not a lot of good here. It looks like we were mostly just getting our asses kicked. And here, a lot of people were put to rest. More migrants. More dwarves are struck down with silver warhammer. Doesn't look like it was any one of our dwarves, though. Nope. Settle, settle, settle. Oh! Tregor! McDirt. Oh, right. That's the... I didn't add him in the previous videos because I kept forgetting and I didn't actually... I don't think he actually requested one, but that is King Isaac Linkser's dwarf. So apparently he settled in midsummer of 156. Honestly, this fort went on a long time. For being one of my forts, that is. They usually make it to the second or third year and then it's screwed. Draylon came back from the dead. Nice. If you want to read any of this, you can just pause the video and read whatever you want. I'm not actually going to sit here and read all through all this history because it's a lot. And here's more people dying from thirst. Cripes. Why do people keep dying from thirst? Rainbow Dash came back as a restless haunt. Tregor McDirt created a masterful gold sarcophagus. Oh, here's our metalsmith or metalcrafter. Or blacksmith, I think it's called. No, he became a metalsmith. Okay. More people died from thirst, and more migrants. Tregor McDirt created blah blah blah, Rainbow Dash was put to rest. Trevor McDirt keeps making masterful builds of coffee guy. Put to rest. More migrants. Trevor McDirt keeps creating masterful things. Okay, seriously. Yes, we know you're a master. More people was put to rest. Sorry, got a bit of a cough tonight. Masterful, masterful, masterful. Yeah, we know. Migrants? Lots of migrants. Jurist McAwesomebane settled in Splashedpost in mid-spring of 158. So, that's the guy who was destined to be killing Jurist McAwesome. Tregor McDirt. In the late spring of 158, the Doom of Cole attacked the Crystal of Oni. The goblin Snubbin Prince Black led the attack. I think that's actually the ones we were killing. The siege we broke. The goblin Snubbin Prince Black was struck down by the dwarf Sand Glaze Lols. Glaze Lols? Really? Struck down. Haha, the goblins are dying. Bled to death. We kicked their ass. Eurismac Awesomebane actually killed a goblin. No, wait. The dwarf Moldath Steelbeans was struck down by the dwarf Eurismac Awesomebane. Moldath, wasn't he our mayor? Seem to remember he was our mayor anyway. And here's King Isaac Linkser now. Settlers! Yay! Did anything else happen? There we go. The dwarf Eurismac picks Recluse Diamond succumbed to an infection, slain by the dwarf. Really? He was He was backstabbed by a dwarf? Really? Who's this Iton Bankhammers? We have to find him later. Remember that name, Iton Bankhammers. Gonna write it down here. Iton Bankhammers. I have to figure out who the hell that guy was. Why he killed your spec pick? Okay, more people settled, and he keeps creating masterful gold things. Ah, here we go. The Doom of Cold. They just keep coming, don't they? Attack the Crystal of Owning at Splashedpost. The Goblin Snodoob Relief Dungeons led the attack. And they defeated us, because they had like 15 trolls. And we starved to death. Including Gears Not Awesome Game. Yeah, I did have a couple of dwarves at the very end. Okay, so let's find this Iton Bankhammers. Important persons, historical figures. Let's see. Iton Bankhammers. Oh, wait. Yeah, that was him. Her, actually. Not him. Alright. She was born in 100. She was of unknown parentage. She settled in Splashedpost. Oh, so she did nothing for 58 years. Really? You're kidding me. That's her history. Okay. She became a member of the Crystal of Owning. She became an enemy of the Doom of Cole. Yeah, no wonder, because they kept attacking us. So then she starved to death. Related historical figures. Logan Diamond Greenness. The Mountainous Blueness. Nice name. Object of Ardent Worship. Rakas, object of faithful worship. So she killed Eurismac Pick. That's her big thing in life. That is balls. She came to the fort, killed Eurismac Pick, and that's it. She did nothing in her life that was worth mentioning. Holy God, all these guys and girls are from Splashedpost. Yeah! Except for the goblins. Okay, let's see. We can take someone at random here. Dr. Couple British. You were born in 69. Holy crap, you were old. And you did also nothing interesting in your life except die to a goblin. Congratulations. And Zengard. Nope. Rainbow Dash. Did nothing interesting except dying from thirst and coming back as a ghost. Roxas. She did nothing important either. Moonshine. Did I do anything? No, and I was also a she. Why are we all she's? Shit. You know what I mean. Wilhelm is also a she. I should start checking the sexes, honestly. Okay, so your stomach pick. Did you do anything interesting? Okay, so he was born in 65. Became a member of the crystal owning. No, nothing interesting until they came to Splashedpost, where his life ended. He became romantically involved with Eurist McMason, which must have been a woman then, I hope. Actually, do we have homosexual dwarves? Sounds wrong, but could work. yeah, he created an artifact. He was struck. Wait, what? He was struck down by Thob Granite Ruff with a copper pick. Okay, that must have been a tantrum. They spring an enemy that didn't call, yeah, because they declared war. Was struck down by Tekhud Cusp Banner with a copper pick. He seems to get his ass kicked a lot. He ceased to be the expedition leader of the Crystal of Owning. Okay. And then he succumbed to an infection by a dwarf. I did have a lover, though. And two kills. Thorpe and Tekhud. Haha! Well, he did pay them back. Apparently, he killed both of them. Oh, struck down. Yeah, I read that wrong. Not that he was struck down by them, but he killed them. Alright. So he liked to kick ass, not get kicked. Oh, well, that works, I guess. Right. So, this is Splashedpost signing off. So, for the next Dwarf Fortress Let's Play, because yes, of course I'm going to make more of these. They're wonderful, and I like doing them, and some of you, I think it's about 30-40 people, like watching them, so I'll keep doing them. For the next one, I'm going to upgrade to the latest version, which includes loads of changes, and I'll try to go over some of them that I know about. But I'd also like for you guys to comment on this video and tell me if you want a dwarf, then state a gender, a name, and a profession. I can't swear I can put you in, because with these strict restrictions, so to speak, it might take a while before you can put in. But otherwise, you can just say, just put my dwarf in and call him this, I don't care. That works too. And also, I'd like for you guys to think up a name for the fort. I'm not actually sure I can just choose a name straight off like that, but if I can, I will. So remember, names for forts in Dwarf Fortress are composed of usually of two names. So I'm gonna show you here. If we go into Dwarf Fortress, blah 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 blah, embark, yes. Prepare to embark. Oops, yeah, that was stupid. I wasn't meaning to do that. I'll do that again, because I pressed the stupid thing. And stop me, ta-da! And work. Here we go. Prepare for the journey carefully. Here we go. Name fortress. So, it can actually be a lot. You can have front compounds, rear compounds, and a lot of things. But usually, they're just two words, like this. Cloister growths. Tomes martyrs. Paddle phrased, floor raised. Yeah, as you can see, nonsense things, really. But let me know if there's any particular ideas you have that sound cool or sound funny or just are generally lols, and I'll look into it. So until next time, toodos.